Jones.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is the FnG Show. Not often do we do things like this because he can't stand science fiction, you know, by the way. But I want to share with you the last part of the battle scene for Star Trek Discovery. For all of my Star Trek fans out there, you know, I got the shirt on, I'm representing. So all of my Star Trek fans out there, many of you love Discovery, some of you don't like it. I'm one of the fans that do like it. We're going to look at the battle scene. And I'm going to interrupt from time to time to talk about some of the things that I like and why I like it.
Well, we shall see. What's the story for us? This is the battle against Control and Star Trek Discovery.
Mission all vessels. Leland's fleet has arrived.
Leland and his ships will give us one hell of a fight.
We are surrounded. All enemy vessels armed and ready.
Mm-hmm.
Shields up.
Prepare for battle.
I know that shit. Oh, that was pretty good. Oh,
battle stations, report.
Shields are maximum, sir. Weapons armed and ready, Captain.
All right, now tell me, while this is going, I know I can see who's supposed to be Captain Kirk. But who's Spock and who's Lieutenant Uhura?
There is no Captain Kirk.
Who's
Lieutenant Uhura is not in this.
And who's
This Enterprise crew is the crew before Captain Kirk.
He's not listening to me. He's not listening. Who on there? I can see who's Captain Kirk, which is the captain or whatever. Ship.
His name is Captain Pike.
So I know who that is because it's obvious. But who is Lieutenant Uhura on here? Like, this is who the part she would play normally play. This is Captain Spock. This is who Spock normally play. Oh, this is beam me up, Scotty. This would be that dude. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, you want to say who's the engineer? You asking me who's the engineer?
Yeah.
The number one, the lady that you saw.
Show me. I mean, when it come on, let me know because I don't remember. I know that's
Captain Pike.
So I know he the captain.
These are Discovery. This is the control officer on the bridge. That's where Sulu and when their ship came along. That's where Sulu and Chekhov used to sit. When their ship came along.
So this was before Captain Kirk came?
Yeah, this is a prequel. This is basically 10 years to 15 to 20 years before, I think.
The front line of defense against the Section 31 fleet. You will lead the attack and draw their fire to give us the time.
Now, Section 31 is a computer program that has taken over a part of Star Trek's secret mission parameters. And apparently this program has gotten out of control with the people who were operating it, and they were going to try to destroy Starfleet and take over and become their own entity. And this whole battle is a result of that, this computer program.
So is that anything like Section 8?
Yes, that's what this is all about.
Well, you know, I said Section 8 as in the housing thing. Is that what the Section 31 is about?
No, it's not the same thing.
See, he don't even listen to me. He's like, yes, that's it.
Time we need. Enterprise will maintain fire on the fleet to cause distraction for as long as we can. But as soon as Burnham is detected out there, we have to keep her safe. Shuttles and pods use attack formation Gamma 6. Squadrons 1 and 3 coordinate positions to disrupt and target all main enemy vessels. This is Starfleet.
Who are they? Who are all them people there?
Communications officer, the black guy's communications officer and operations officer was the lady with the thing over her head.
I mean, who is that opposed to the people? Like, which one is Lieutenant Uhura or whatever?
The communication officer would have been Lieutenant Uhura, the black guy's the communications officer on the Enterprise here, on Discovery. He doesn't understand anything about Star Trek, ladies and gentlemen. Now, there have been a lot of people who talked about the original Star Trek bridge from 1960 to the new reformed bridge in the updated version of the Star Trek Enterprise here. One of the reasons why this bridge looks so much more computerized than the original series from 1960 is because they didn't have the technology back then to make it look this well, but it still models the original bridge from 1960 with the red all on the red panels and the red things in the middle and all that stuff. So, and it was the actual Enterprise before Enterprise 1701. I don't know if this is Enterprise 1701, which Captain Pike was commander. I'll have to check that, ladies and gentlemen, but it may have been 1700, but 1701 was with Captain Kirk, but I may not be correct on that. And I know all of you out there who are experts in this will probably correct me and lambast me if I get it wrong.
Fire full spread.
They need a Millennium Falcon.
That's the communications officer.
But I mean, that don't mean anything, man. Who is that from the first, in the original Star Trek?
Who's who?
Who would she be in?
She wouldn't. She wasn't. There was
what
nothing.
About the other one? The other guy standing next to her?
No, nothing connected to the original. Mm. None of these are connected to the original.
He's not understanding anything.
Their positions are not the same. Commander Durham, her position is a totally different position than any position on the original. She was just a commander. Mm. She was just a commanding officer on the bridge. So it's not the same as the original positions of the original Star Trek. You had Lieutenant Uhura, Spock, Dr. McCoy. There's a doctor on this ship. You have Dr. McCoy, you have Sulu, you have Chekhov. The two people that sit in the front of the screen are the same positions that Sulu and Chekhov would have sat in.
0.0, 2.3, and 4.2.
I'm on it, I got it.
She used to be in Orange is the New Black.
Oh, she played in Columbiana too. See, Sulu would have sat there and kept Chekhov would have sat on the other side. I think I got that right. And that's the Enterprise, Enterprise bridge right there.
They're going to make a run on weakening Discovery's shields.
She played on a show we used to watch.
Mm-hmm.
She
like
buck teeth.
Mm-hmm.
One bring us around and place us between those drones and Discovery.
Aye, Captain.
1701.
Yep, 1701. I guess I had it wrong, but it's 1701, but it's a earlier version of 1701. Now,
1701.
I like this because you would not see something like this on a television show. This is what you would call movie quality, blockbuster type battle scenes that they have put a lot of work into Discovery to make this battle scene work. It was an epic battle scene by any stretch of the means that I have ever seen for a television show that's on TV. You can hear the phasers. You can hear all of that stuff firing. You can just hear everything. Look at the explosions.
That's the other ship. That's the same ship?
Yeah, it's the same one. That's the Enterprise right there.
Hi, Captain.
The entire fleet is receiving signals from Leland inside that ship.
So,
take a bite out of summer.
From what you understand of science fiction, what do you think?
I mean, it'd be a good thing to watch, as far as the action and stuff. But, just to see the scene, I would have to see what led up to it. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, it was a long season. So, it was a very long season.
So I don't know who's attacking them or why they're attacking them or how many were attacking them.
It was a computer program that went out of whack and tried to take over.
Mm.
And they had to get it under control.
Interesting. But yeah, that's some good. They did a good job with all that. With the phasers and the...
Yeah, the explosions, the ships, the all of that was very good.
Good job. Especially, like you said, you see that in the theater.
Yeah.
Not to see it weekly.
Not to see stuff like that weekly. And I mean, Discovery has been like that the whole season with battle scenes. And they show you exactly, well, back in the 60s when they fire a phaser or on kill, you couldn't really see it. And when they fire a phaser on this, with the technology now, you can actually see what the phaser does. It fries you, and you can see all your organs frying all up. They just show all the
interesting.
And by the way, ladies and gentlemen, I don't know if you know this, but Quentin Tarantino wants to direct a Star Trek movie.
They need to let him.
And if they do, it is going to be off the chain.
Mm-hmm. Because they're going to have Django bust up out on it. No. The wolf. Nah, that's good, man. Any final words, man?
No, I'm glad. Season 3 of Discovery is going to be on in 2 days. 3 days.
Well, he shall see. Yeah, I'm sure he'll let me know what's going on with it when it comes on. Yeah,
he won't be watching it, ladies and gentlemen, but I may try to see
if I get into it. But it's a third season, so if I binge watch 1 and 2, I might get into it, but we shall see.
Yeah.
We'll see. But that is it for us for right now. Yeah, this is the Battle Against Control.
Uh-huh.
Star Trek Discovery.
Yep.
So this was the last episode before the finale right there.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so I guess we will see what happens in season 3.
Yeah, season 3.
Episode 1. With that, ladies and gentlemen, this is the FnG Show, and we are out.
We are out.